Welcome to Microwave Engineering Playlist. Here in this session, I'll be explaining cavity resonator. And this session that I'm making based on request done by one of my students online. So let us begin this session with following outlines, where first I'll explain you basics of cavity resonator. Then I'll explain performance parameter of cavity resonator. Then I'll explain you different types of cavity resonator, and then we will see conditions for resonance and modes of cavity resonator. So let us begin this session with first point, that is basics of cavity resonator. So see, what is cavity resonator? First of all, it is hollow metallic enclosed tube exhibits resonance behavior when excited by electromagnetic field. So basically you will be finding cavity resonator, that is what? Hollow metallic enclosed tube which exhibits resonance behavior when excited by electromagnetic field. I'll explain how resonance happens and what is the condition for resonance in detail at last. Mainly, it is been utilized in oscillator, tuned amplifier, frequency meters and phase equalizers. So these are the places where we usually use cavity resonator: oscillator, tuned amplifier, frequency meters and phase equalizer. You will be finding cavity resonator that is functioning at greater than 3 gigahertz. So usually in microwave we use cavity resonator. As if we see microwave signal, then it is having two different properties. One is when you work with microwave, it exhibits lumped element. And as it exhibits lumped element, what will happen is it is very difficult to obtain high quality factor. So we need to go for cavity resonator. So lumped elements that will exhibits problem related to high quality factor. The reason is quality factor is purely based on resonance frequency as well as bandwidth, and bandwidth is depending on impedance elements which is there inside of circuit. So at microwave it is very difficult to obtain high quality factor. At microwave frequency is very high, and because of high frequency small physical dimensions are there, and as if you have very small physical dimensions, that will be providing limits to voltage and current requirements. So these are the basic problems which is what not allowing us to have conventional circuit. So for that we need to go for resonator, and out of different resonators available in the market, I will be explaining in this session cavity resonator. There could be coaxial resonator, there could be transmission line resonator, but here I'll be explaining cavity resonator. So these are the difficulties which is what not allowing us to have conventional circuit as a resonator circuit. So let us move on to next point, that is performance parameter of cavity resonator. Now first performance parameter of cavity resonator, that is resonance frequency. And resonance frequency that will be 2A or 2B, where A and B, that is what, width and thickness of rectangular waveguide. So based on width and thickness of rectangular waveguide, we can directly calculate resonance frequency FR. Quality factor, that is frequency of resonance divided by 3 dB bandwidth of signal. So quality factor that we can calculate by frequency FR divided by 3 dB bandwidth. Like see, if you have response, I'm just plotting one response here, where here frequency is there, here there is amplitude, and if you see this kind of response is there, in that case if I say here amplitude is maximum, so at here frequency will be FR, that is resonance frequency, and from maximum if you go 3 dB down, then this will be the width, that is what, bandwidth. So this is bandwidth. 3 dB down, this is what, bandwidth. So this FR divided by this bandwidth, that is what, quality factor. Now third performance parameter, that is input impedance. Now why do we need to understand what is input impedance of cavity resonator? The reason is, when you use cavity resonator, we need to match that resonator with output circuit. So it is so essential to understand what is input impedance of cavity resonator, then we can have its connection with output circuit, so that there will be proper impedance matching and that can be used in circuit. So these three performance parameter, that is so essential when we study cavity resonator. Now let us have different types of cavity resonator. Mainly there are two types of cavity resonator. One is rectangular cavity resonator and second is cylindrical cavity resonator. I'll explain both of this in this session, so it will be more clear how we use cavity resonator, what will be resonance frequency of it, and what is the condition for resonance. So all those things that we'll be discussing here. So as I have told, there are basically two types of cavity resonator. One is rectangular cavity resonator and second is cylindrical cavity resonator. One can see rectangular cavity resonator that I have placed here, where this cavity resonator, that is what, short circuited from both of the sides. So it is actually a complete box, right? It is terminated as a short circuit from both of the sides. So here at this phase there is metal, as well as at this phase there is metal. In cylindrical cavity resonator, even we need to terminate it with metals here. So here there will be metal at this phase, as well as at this phase there will be metal. So this is how cavity resonators are there physically. Now I have already explained you rectangular and cylindrical waveguide. So in that we have derived electric field and magnetic field, as well as modes of propagation. So I have already explained, in waveguide only TE and TM mode is possible. TEM mode is not possible in rectangular and cylindrical waveguide, that we have already discussed. So when we talk about what are the modes which is possible in cavity resonator, so at that time there are only two types of modes which is possible: transverse electric and transverse magnetic mode. That is only possible in cavity resonator. So only two modes are possible, but here third dimension is getting added, so we need to write TEMNP. Now if you see my previous session based on rectangular and cylindrical waveguide, I was been discussing modes based on TEMN, but now I need to discuss it as per TEMNP, where M, that was there with respect to side A, N, that was there with respect to side B. Now we need to add P, that is what exactly there with respect to side L. So TEMNP, TMMNP, that is what I need to say. And similar case that is there for cylindrical cavity resonator, in which with respect to x-axis we need to say there is N, with respect to y-axis we need to say there is M, and with respect to Z along with L we need to say there is P. So that is how possibility of modes are there. So only two types of modes which is possible: transverse electric and transverse magnetic mode. Now what is the condition for resonance? So we need to understand one thing here: when you want to have resonance, at that time it should generate standing pattern. So to have a resonance, it is compulsory to have standing pattern. Other than standing pattern, you cannot have resonance. So first, if I say signal is propagating along with the z direction, in both of the waveguides signal is propagating along with Z direction. So how we can have standing pattern? Now see, when signal is propagating along with the Z direction, at that time to have a standing pattern, it should be very compulsory. It should propagate with the super multiple of guided wavelength. Like see, if I say my signal is propagating along with the Z direction and my guided wavelength, that is lambda G. So in that case, condition is it should be super multiple of lambda by 2 when it propagates. So what will happen is, like, when it goes in this direction, right, and when it reflects from this phase and again it goes back in this direction, at that time if it is out of phase, then there will be subtraction, so resonance will not happen. So to have resonance, it is very compulsory this length L, that should be super multiple of lambda G by 2. So what will happen is, like, see, if signal is happening in this direction with lambda G by 2, see, this is what lambda G by 2, right? This is what lambda G by 2 right now. So in that case, when it reflects from here, it will be generating standing pattern inside. So there will be no out of phase subtraction. So signal will not get deteriorated. If I say it is lambda G, so in that case what will happen is, like, you can see how signal will propagate. So this is what lambda G. So here length L is equals to lambda G. So in that case, even it will be generating standing pattern. So similarly, for if I say from here to phase, this phase, if signal is 3 times of lambda G by 2, like this, so this length, now that is lambda G by 2 3 times. So in that case, it will be generating standing pattern. So when it generates standing pattern, you will be finding it will be creating resonance. So the basic condition for resonance is this length L, that should be super multiple of lambda G by 2, and dominant mode that will happen at P is equals to 1. So dominant mode happen at L is equals to lambda G by 2, so that you can have L, that is what lambda G by 2, at that time there will be a dominant mode. So see, this is how cylindrical and rectangular cavity resonators are there. So physically you'll be observing it is complete box and all sides are there with metal. So when signal propagates along with the Z direction, it will get reflect, and that is how it will continuously reflect from each other faces. And when it get reflects from other faces, there should not be subtraction of signal, and to not get subtracted signal, this length L, that should be super multiple of lambda G by 2, so that there will be resonance, and that is what cavity resonator. Thank you so much for watching this video. I hope that you have understood this session. I have made it based on the request done by one student online. You can give your valuable suggestions. Definitely based on it, in future I'll make videos. Thank you so much for watching this video.